A study on more than 800 adults has revealed the number one thing that predicts weight loss success, and it wasn't calories or carbs or fat. In fact, the type of diet didn't matter at all. What really mattered was one simple habit, and the people who followed it lost almost double the weight in just 6 months. So if you've been frustrated with stubborn belly fat, or you felt like you've tried everything and nothing sticks, this could be the piece that you're missing. And when you hear what it is, it's going to completely flip the way that you think about losing weight. Okay, so what is this number one predictor of weight loss, and how can you take advantage of it to finally see results? Like I said, researchers followed more than 800 adults who were overweight and obese. Each person was on a totally different kind of diet. Some were told to cut fat, others loaded up on protein. On the surface, these diets couldn't have looked more different. But after 6 months, when the results came in, one thing jumped off the page. The type of diet didn't matter. What mattered most, the single strongest predictor of weight loss, was how much fiber people ate. That's right. It turns out that fiber is the number one thing you should be paying attention to if you're trying to lose weight. Now, before you go thinking fiber is the whole story, I need to be clear. It wasn't the only factor at play. The people who got results also made a few other changes that are important and were important in losing weight. And I'll walk you through what those were in a moment, but stay tuned. First, let's talk about what the study actually found with fiber, because it's probably not what you expected, and it's not something a lot of people talk about. What shocked the researchers was how much different even a small increase in fiber made. People who simply ate a little more fiber each day lost extra weight without changing anything else about their diet. And when they compared the people who made only a slight change to the ones who really boosted their fiber, the gap was dramatic. The high fiber group lost almost double the weight of the low fiber group. That's the kind of edge most people are missing when they can't get the scale to budge. And not only did it not matter what kind of diet they were on, it also didn't matter how old they were or whether they were a man or a woman. Fiber predicted success across the board, which means if you've struggled with belly fat, stubborn cravings, or weight loss that just won't stick, this is one of the easiest levers that you can pull. That's why I was so excited to bring this study to you. Now I'm about to explain why fiber is such a game changer when trying to lose weight. But before I do, please take a second to like this video. Doing so helps a lot of people discover this information so that they can start getting better results too. So why does fiber make such a difference? Two big reasons. The first thing fiber does is change how filling your food feels. You can eat the same amount of food, but if it's rich in fiber, you'll feel more satisfied on far fewer calories. For example, picture a bowl of raspberries and then a bowl of chips. Now, they might look about the same size in the bowl. The impact on your body is completely different, isn't it? But the main reason is since the berries are packed with fiber, they leave you full and satisfied. The chips, on the other hand, are almost fiber-free, so you can keep eating and eating until your body feels like it's had enough. Second, fiber slows down how quickly the food you eat turns into sugar in your blood. Normally, when you eat something like white bread or the chips or soda, the sugar hits your system all at once. As a result, your energy shoots up and then crashes, which leaves you tired and craving more. But when there's fiber in the mix, it's like putting a slow release valve on that sugar, that glucose. Your body absorbs it gradually, so your energy remains steady and your appetite stays under control. Now, here's where it gets really interesting. Fiber doesn't just help you lose more weight. It also helps you stick to your weight loss plan. The people in the study who stayed consistent with their diets were averaging about 25 grams of fiber a day, and they dropped around 20 pounds in 6 months. Meanwhile, the ones who kept slipping averaged 21 grams, and they only lost 14 pounds. Just a few extra grams of fiber gave people the willpower to stay on track, and that consistency added up to 6 more pounds being gone. That is an extra pound per month. So what does this mean for you? If you want the kind of results that the top performers in this study got, you've got to hit the same daily target, roughly 20 to 25 grams of fiber if you're a woman, 30 to 38 if you're a man. Now here's the catch. Almost nobody is getting there. Over 90% of women and 97% of men fall short on fiber intake every day. The average American only gets 16 grams of fiber daily. That shortfall is one of the biggest reasons weight loss feels like such an uphill battle. Here's the other catch. A lot of people hear this and then they immediately go out and buy a fiber supplement. And then they try to fill the gap with high fiber cereals or bars or powders. Those are just processed foods. foods with a sprinkle of fiber added in. And along with it often comes sugar, rancid oils, and artificial sweeteners and ingredients that actually make fat loss harder. Instead, the kind of fiber that worked in this study, the kind of fiber that truly drives results, comes from real food. And there are a lot of great options for you to choose from. Some of the best places to get it include leafy greens like spinach, kale, arugula. These are really easy to add into a morning smoothie to get extra fiber. Cruciferous vegetables, broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, cabbage. We almost always at the Livingood household have these chopped up in a bowl to be eaten with hummus or a healthy form of ranch. Seeds, chia, flax, pumpkin. So easy to add into a smoothie, or you can check out my chia seed water video for a really easy cheat to add in some extra fiber and help you feel full after a meal. Nuts like almonds and walnuts, berries, raspberries, blackberries, blueberries, avocados, legumes, lentils, black beans. I love, they're a great source of magnesium. Split peas, whole food grains as well. It's got to be a little bit careful with grains, but quinoa and barley, these sprouted whole forms of these, the body can tolerate very well. And here's the best part. These foods don't just give you fiber. They are loaded with vitamins and minerals and antioxidants that help your liver detox. They balance your hormones. They help heal your gut. So in other words, they're the foods your body was designed to thrive on. And when you fill your body with what it actually needs, it's no surprise that the weight starts coming off fast. It releases it. So how do you use fiber to lose weight? Now, as powerful as fiber is, the people in this study didn't simply eat more broccoli and call it a day. There were other habits in place that made the fiber even more effective. And if you want the same results, these are the pieces that you can't miss. First, every participant was eating on a plan that cut down their overall consumption. Usually that equates to removing up to 750 calories of food per day. And it can sound like a lot, but here's the important part. They didn't feel like they were starving themselves. They're just curbing consumption down. That's because when your meals are full of fiber-rich foods, berries, seeds, legumes, you can eat portions that feel big and satisfy while still keeping calories under control. That's why the participants could cut back without constantly battling hunger. And this is where I like to incorporate in a little bit of fasting as well, whether it's intermittent or night fasting or OMAD. I have lots of videos on the channel breaking those practices down because it's an easy way to curb the consumption and then focus on a fiber-rich, healthy meal. Secondly, they were moving their bodies. Nothing extreme, just 90 minutes of moderate activity spread out across the week. That could mean a 30-minute walk three times a week or even shorter high-intensity sessions. If you want an even easier and more effective option, consider high-intensity interval training instead. Research shows it achieves the same fat loss results as moderate activity, and it does it in half and sometimes the third of the amount of time. So instead of 30 minutes of walking 3 days a week, you could try a 10-minute workout 5 days a week and get the same benefits. So for those who are interested, here's how it works. Pick three simple movements: squats, push-ups, jumping jacks. Do the first one for 50 seconds and then take a break and a rest for 10 seconds. Then go to the next in 50 seconds and then take a break for 10 seconds. And then go to the next for 50 seconds and then take a 40-second break. Repeat that two more rounds for a 9-minute and 50-second workout and you're done for the day. You're on track to burn just as much fat as the people in the study. Which brings us to the third factor. Aside from fiber that resulted in weight loss in the study, their participants stayed consistent. Most diets and attempts at losing weight fall apart because people can't keep them up for longer than a few weeks. This is why I don't generally recommend long-term carnivore or even vegan or vegetarian, because we just have these vices and then we end up failing. I don't like the word diet or programs. Those are swear words around Dr. Livingood. Hunger, cravings, and energy crashes pull us off track when we're in those modes. But when fiber kept people full and their blood sugar stayed steady, it gave them the staying power to follow their plan for 6 full months. And that's what made the difference between modest weight loss and the kind of double-digit results that the researchers saw in the higher fiber group. Now, this study showed that fiber is the number one predictor of weight loss. But here's what most people don't realize. There's actually a way to use fiber to lose even more weight, even faster than what these researchers found. That's because fiber works best when it's paired with other strategies that not only curb your eating, but also heal your body so that you can finally burn fat the way that it's supposed to. And that's exactly what I will show you inside my other video, the 30-day blueprint to lose 20 pounds of fat. Fiber is a key part of the plan, but it's also built into a complete system step by step with the exact foods to eat, the daily habits to build, and then the boosters that accelerate fat loss. So if you're excited about using fiber to lose weight fast and want a plan to help you start putting into action right now, then click here to watch this video next, and I'll see you there.